Hello students, in this session we are going to learn about petroleum. Petroleum is another type of fossil fuel. Just like coal that we have learned in our previous session. I am going to recall the previous session that fossil fuel. Fossil fuel means what? The dead remains of a life that acting as a fuel. Fuel is the energy source. So fossils means the dead remains of life. Life means plants or animals. After their death, if they buried inside the earth, what will happen? They act as a fuel. Means we get some energy source from that dead remain. And if we combine that word, it is fossil fuel. So one by one, we will briefly discuss about petroleum. Petroleum is a fossil fuel that is obtained by the decomposition of dead animals and plants due to the geological changes under the earth. It means oil from the rocks. Petroleum, it is a dark oily liquid that is insoluble in water. Have you ever performed the experiment like just take one or means in one vessel take a oil and try to add that oil into a water. Check the result. What will happen? Oil and water get mix with each other? No, never. Why? Because water is dense than the oil, and that's why oil is come upside the water surface. Okay, and that will coat the water. Yes, and water goes down because it is highly dense than the oil. Okay, and they both form a separate layers. Getting? So petroleum is also a form of oil. Yes, it is a dark oil liquid that is insoluble, means not mix with water. Okay, next. Okay, here one story about petroleum formation. How petroleum form? So in the ocean 300 to 400 million years ago, what had happened that tiny sea plants and animals died and were buried on the ocean floor. And over the time, they are covered by layers of sand and sediment, which turn into sedimentary rock. Okay? Ocean 50 to 100 million years ago, over millions of years, the remains were buried deeper and deeper, where the enormous heat and pressure from inside the earth and the rock above turn them into oil and gas. Okay, so sedimentary rock, if we deep or if we drill that sedimentary rock, inside the rock what is there? It is oil and gas deposits are there, and heat and pressure turn the dead plants into a coal. So just I have mentioned over here, petroleum means oil from the rocks. So the dead plants and the animals, they form a rock, sedimentary rock. Okay, because the sand which cover these dead plants and animals, and by that sedimentary rock will form. And this sedimentary rock, on this again there is a buried deeper and deeper, what buried? The another remains of life are buried on that sedimentary rock, and the thickness of this sedimentary rock will increase, and heat and pressure applies on this sedimentary rock, and because of that they turn the dead plants and animals into a oil and gas or into a petroleum. Okay, so it is the story about petroleum formation. Just we have discussed about the coal. Okay, so like that petroleum will form. So look at here in your text book, there is a figure number 5.4. So it shows that, look at this diagram, it shows that deposit of petroleum and natural gas, okay, you see that layer containing petroleum oil and gas is above of the water. Why is it so? Yes, just we have discussed that this oil and gas are more, have a less density than the water, means water is highly dense than this two factor, and that's why oil and gas is on the above of this water. Getting? Next is refining of petroleum. Refining means what? Okay, so petroleum is a dark oily liquid and has a foul smell, or which has an unpleasant odor, means not having a nice smell. Okay, it has a foul smell. Petroleum contains many constituents like petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax. These all are constituents of petroleum. Okay, so we have to separate this constituent of petroleum. Okay, so the process of separating these various constituents of a petroleum is known as refining. Getting? What is refining? Petroleum is a whole substance and it has many constituents like petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax. So this all there in the petroleum. So we have to separate these constituents. Okay, and the process of separating these various constituents of petroleum, it is known as refining. And for what we separate out? We separate for the petroleum. So it is known as petroleum refinery. Getting? Separation of constituents of petroleum. The process which carried out for this, it is known as refining. So it is petroleum refining. And this is carried out as a petroleum refinery. Getting? Okay, next. So it is somewhat process of refining. So look at here, it is a furnace in which the crude oil which they get from the ocean. So from that, the crude oil which is there, which put inside this furnace, and there is another vesicle or another big tank over there. In that, there is happen the process like in which the separate constituents of petroleum will get separate out. So look at here, the gasoline means petrol, kerosene, yes, diesel oil, fuel oil, and lubricating oil or the paraffin wax will separate out. So if we heat this crude oil at 150 degrees, so at 20 degree gas will liberate, 150 degree Celsius gasoline will separate out, at 200 degree Celsius kerosene will separate out, at 300 degree Celsius diesel oil will separate out, at 370 degree Celsius fuel oil will separate out, and at 400 degree Celsius lubricating oil, paraffin wax will separate out from this crude oil. Getting? Next. Okay, so in the industry, such big tanks are there, and in this big tank, the process of refining will carried out, and by this refining process, there will be a separation of these constituents or components of a petroleum. Okay. So here I have mentioned some constituents of petroleum with their uses. So one by one I'm just reading. Liquefied petroleum gas means the LPG as a fuel for home and industry. So we have this liquefied petroleum gas at our home, yes, and that act as a fuel for home and the industry. Petrol, yes, to run our vehicles, we need this petrol. So as a fuel for automobiles and a solvent for dry cleaning. So for the clothes dry cleaning, we need a petrol. Kerosene, yes, as a fuel for stoves and lamps, etc. Diesel, yes, it is also fuel for automobiles, heavy motor vehicles, as well as for the generators. Lubricating oil for the lubrication. Okay, paraffin wax. Paraffin wax means our Vaseline is a kind of paraffin wax. We use this paraffin wax in ointments, in formation of candles. We use paraffin wax as well as for Vaseline. Bitumen. Bitumen for making paints, surfacing roads, etc. We need the bitumen. Okay, so these are all constituents of petroleum and their uses. So read this table again and again and go through this. Okay, so LPG as a fuel for home and industry, petrol fuel for automobiles and solvent for dry cleaning, kerosene as fuel for stoves and lamps, diesel as a fuel for heavy motor vehicles and generators, lubricating oil for lubrication, paraffin wax in ointments, candles and Vaseline, we use paraffin wax, bitumen for making paints and surfacing roads, etc. Okay, next part is of natural gas. Okay, so look at this. Yeah, it is a flame of our gas stove. Yes, so natural gas is another significant fossil fuel and it is really convenient to send it through pipes. Yes, natural gas is stored under high pressure as compressed natural gas, CNG. We have this in our home. Yes, CNG tank, and because of that we will easily burn our gas stove. Yes, so it has a pipes. Okay, it has a pipe connection and through that it connect our gas stove and the CNG tank. Okay, so it is convenient to send it through pipes. So that's why it is under high pressure as compressed natural gas we can store. In our country, natural gas has been found in Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and in the Krishna Godavari Delta. Okay, compressed natural gas, that is CNG, the symbol is this CNG, that is compressed natural gas. So some advantages of using this CNG means it causes less pollution than other fossil fuel. Petroleum, that we know that petrol and diesels are diesel, means if they burn inside the air, that will form a gases which is harmful for the environment, means they will form, it is linked with the global warming. Yes, okay, so why? Because they produce some carbon dioxide in more concentration and that will harmful for the earth. And compared to that, CNG, it causes less pollution. It is a cleaner fuel. CNG is cleaner fuel. Moreover, it can be used directly at homes and factories for burning and other purposes, as it can be easily transported through pipes. Such network of pipelines exist in Vadodara, that is located in Gujarat, and some parts of Delhi and other places. Okay, so next, look at here, these all are gas lines or the pipelines for transportation of this natural gas. Okay, applications of this fuel is that natural gas we use as a fuel in automobiles. This natural gas we can use as a starting material for manufacturing of many chemicals and fertilizers. Yes, fertilizer means that promote the growth of plants. For that we need a natural gas. Natural gas is used in a power generation plant. Natural gas we use directly as a burning fuel in homes and factories that we know. Okay, so there is one reason that why petroleum is known as black gold. Tell me why petroleum is known as black gold. Because many useful substances are obtained from a petroleum and natural gas. These are termed as petrochemicals. These all petrochemicals used for making various or for manufacturing various useful things. Look at here, petroleum used to make a medicines, toothbrush that we regularly use, toiletries, electronics, candles, sunglasses, clothing, sports equipment, running shoes, jet fuel, fertilizers, automobile, bicycle. For these many things we need a petroleum. Okay, so hydrogen gas obtained from a natural gas is used for production of fertilizer. Okay, so due to this petroleum has a great commercial value. Okay, for this petroleum gives so much money, means it has a commercial value, and because of that petroleum, which is a dark oily liquid, it is blackish color, so it is called as black gold because it gives so much money. Okay, so that's why petroleum is known as black gold. Getting? Next. Okay, so there are some limitations for using a natural resources. Natural resources, tell me, what is natural resources? The resources which we get from nature itself, it is called as natural resources. So fossil fuels like coal, petroleum, etc. needs a millions of years to get transformed from dead bodies to fuels. Yes, it is means this process require millions of years. It is not occur within a 1 year or within a 2 year. It will require millions of years to transform these dead bodies into a fuel. Yes, so but currently this demand of these natural resources are high, and it will require 100 years to reform these natural resources, and because of that there will be a scarcity of these resources. Okay, so it will cause a limitations on a natural resources. We have to use these natural resources wisely because it has a limited storage. Okay, air pollution is caused when these fuels are burnt. Yes, and these fuels are responsible for the problems associated with the global warming, because if we burn coal, if we burn petroleum constituents, it will liberate out carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrous oxide. Yes, we heard about this, and these all gases cause air pollution, so it will pollute our air. So it will relate to global warming. Yes, temperature of earth will increases, getting, and that will cause another effect on a earth. So these all natural gases or all the fossil fuel, if we burn, they cause a air pollution. Hence it is very much important to use these fuels wisely. Getting? Next. Some preventive measures to save fuels by Petroleum Conservation Research Association, PCRA. What is Petroleum Conservation Research Association? They give some preventive measure to save fuel because they have a limited resources, or they have a, because it is which kind of source? Inexhaustible or exhaustible? Natural, these resources are exhaustible. They have a certain limitations on their several uses. Okay, so drive vehicles at average and a constant speed. Okay, so that will save our fuel. When not necessary, shut down the vehicle's engines. Yes, make sure pressure in tires is correct. Always keep vehicles under good condition, and it will ultimately lead the savage of a fuels. Okay, So there are three R's to save the environment: reduce, recycle and reuse. So what we have to reduce means use less, save the resource by not wasting them. Recycle, segregate the waste that can be recycled and used to make required thing. Reuse, use the things again and again, and that will help us to save the environment, because natural resources are not meant to us, means we have to save that natural resources for our further generation, because they have a right to use that natural resources like us. So we have to use these three R's to save the environment as well as to save the resources. Getting? Okay, so summary of this topic, it is a little bit a small topic, that is coke, coal tar and coal gas are the products of coal, petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, kerosene, paraffin wax, lubricating oil are obtained by refining of petroleum. Coal and petroleum resources are limited. We should use them judiciously. Okay, so this all we have learned in this topic. This topic is little bit a small topic, but it is very important to learn that we have to save, we have to reuse, we have to recycle, and we have to use these natural resources very wisely. Getting? So revise this session. Okay, thank you so much for watching this session.